Here I'm asked to solve a quadratic inequality. The first thing I'm going to do is factor it. So in the numerator, I'm going to factor that difference of squares, a plus b times a minus b. Also, in the denominator, I see difference of squares as well, so a plus b times a minus b, where a is x and b is 5. Okay, so that's an equivalent form of the original. First step is to determine the critical values. Now, the critical values are the zeros of the numerator and the zeros of the denominator. So here we're going to get four critical values. And we can do this by inspection. Notice x equals negative 3 is a zero for this factor. Also, x equals positive 3 is a zero. Now, the denominator, what makes the denominator zero here is x equals negative 5. And also x equals 5. Okay, those are actually restrictions. Restrictions to the domain, but we're going to include them in the list of critical values. So we had four critical values here. Now let's make a sine chart. Okay, here's a number line. Now, since we had a strict inequality, I'm going to use open dots for all of the critical values. So an open dot at negative 3. An open dot at negative 5. We would use an open dot at those restrictions anyways. And then over here at 3 and again at 5. So when I do that, those values will break the number line up into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 intervals. Okay, so what we're going to do then is test each interval to see if the sign is positive or negative. So here let's choose a number in this interval, say x equals 10. And let's plug it in. So it's always easier to use the factored form. When I plug in 10 here, 10 plus 3 is 13. That's going to be a positive factor times 10 minus 3 is positive. Don't really care what the numbers are, I'm just worried if it's positive or negative. 10 plus 5 is positive. And then in the denominator, 10 minus 5 is positive. Okay, when you multiply and divide four positives, you're going to be left with a result that is positive. So in that interval, everything's positive. So let's choose a number in this interval. Say x equals 4 would be the easiest way to go. Substituting 4 in, 4 plus 3 is positive. 4 minus 3 is positive. Divided by 4 plus 5 is positive. And then 4 minus 5 is negative. So when I multiply and divide here with one negative, the result's going to be negative. So any number I choose in that interval will yield a negative result. Okay, so let's continue testing our intervals. When I choose x equals 0, you can look at the original. If I plug 0 into the original here, I'll have zeros here for x, leaving me with minus 9 over negative 25, which is positive. Okay, but if I go through the factors, you'll see you get the same thing. 0 would be a positive, a 0 here would be negative. So positive times a negative. Let me write that just as a negative. And in the denominator, plugging in 0, I have a positive times a negative. Okay, so two negatives and two positives, multiplying and dividing yields a positive number. That's what, well, we knew that anyway. So let's continue here, testing x equals negative 4. Negative 4 plus 3 is negative. Negative 4 minus 3 is negative. Okay, divided by negative 4 plus 5 is positive. And then if I plug in negative 4 there, I get negative. Okay, so here I have three negatives, which will end up being negative. And then the last interval to test is the very left interval here. Let's say negative 10, let's plug in. Doesn't matter which number you choose. Okay, so negative 10 plus 3 is negative. Negative 10 minus 3 is negative. Okay, so divided by negative 10 plus 5 is negative. And negative 10 minus 5 is negative. Okay, so four negatives, the result will be positive. Okay, so this is our sine chart. Now the last step is to answer the question. We're going to use this sine chart to determine where this rational expression is less than zero. Less than zero means negative. Okay, so here you could see all these x values produce a negative result, and all these x values produce a negative result. So these are all the solutions shaded in on a number line. We want to convert that then to interval notation. Okay, so for this interval we have a round parentheses indicating non-inclusive, negative 5 to negative 3, union from 3 to 5. Okay, so this is interval notation for these x values that are shaded, and all those x values I could plug in here to get a negative result.